Disclaimer: I am not trying to cut cost here. I am planning to gain some practical knowledge and share the same with you all. This is going to be a beginner series where I explain many parts in detail. So if you are a pro, then some parts of the video may be already familiar to you. Hi everyone, welcome to another video with me JCRP on Media Milan. A makerspace is never complete without any fast method to prototype an electronics project. And the longest process in it is to make the PCBs. Till now I've been using this toner transfer method and ferric chloride. You can watch the video by clicking on the top right corner. Etching method involves many steps: the printing, transfer, corrections after transfer, etching, scrubbing, and then drilling holes before I finally get to solder. Now you can understand why I desperately want a PCB milling machine. After I design the PCB on the computer, I just want to click a button and the PCB should be ready. A PCB milling machine costs about 35,000 Indian rupees. But what's the fun in it if we can't make our own? In this part, I will show you how I built the frame. I am using this 30 by 30 aluminium extrusion. It's a T-slot type with a small ridge. Unfortunately, in Pune, I haven't come across a dealer who sells a V-slot aluminium extrusion, which looks like this. The difference between a T-slot and a V-slot is its shape. This is a T-slot nut which slides in between the ridges, and an Allen key screws in from the top. This is what we'll be using to fasten most of our frame. You can buy the T-slot nut from the same dealer who sells you the aluminum extrusions, but to buy the Allen key, you can do it from our hardware. It's cheap if you buy it from there. To cut the aluminum extrusions to the required size, I use this aluminum cutting blade on my miter saw. This is a KYK aluminum cutting blade which is around 100 teeth and runs at 5000 RPM. Make sure that you use a proper blade to cut your aluminum and not your wood cutting blade, because obviously it's going to dull it. This blade gives you a clean cut and a perfect 90 degree, which is important so that when I stack them on top of each other, I can be sure that the cut pieces are actually perpendicular. If you don't have a miter saw, you can ask the dealer to cut them for you. Now I'll start assembling the frame. Here are all the pieces that are cut to length. Two short pieces, two long pieces, and this frame. I've already built the X-axis, but we will talk about it a bit later. I'm using this Allen key wrench made by TVS. They are supposed to be the best. The base is built with these four pieces. The long pieces form the sides and the short piece goes in between them. This is a corner block. As the name implies, it fits on the corner joining both the pieces. To fasten it, I will drop the Allen key screw and attach it to the T-nut. This will be held loosely so that I can slide it in the T-slot. The other aluminium extrusion also slides in from the other side. All the while, I make sure it sits flush to the end of the other piece. Then I can tighten the Allen key screw. Here are both the halves ready. I have kept each side open so that I can drop in some Allen screws. Let me explain. There will be a smooth rod here and a motor on the inner side. So if I don't drop in the screws now, then later I have to disassemble and put it all back together. So don't miss this step. So four screws on the top and two screws on the inside. If you don't understand, that's perfectly fine. You will see later. Now I close both the halves with some more corner blocks. A last check to see if I have the number of screws right. All the while, I made sure that all the sides are flush to each other. This ensures a perfect 90 degree Y-axis. Now the X-axis frame. I have basically made the same kind of connections using corner blocks. These two pieces of extrusion in between provide the lateral support required. To make the fittings easy, I made sure that the corner blocks are flush to the top. In fact, all the corner blocks touch each other. This way, I can be sure that the two rails run parallel to each other. Once I loosen the T-nut at the base of the X-axis frame, I can slide it into the Y-axis frame. Again, here I make sure that this corner block is flush to the base. So basically, wherever necessary, I use the corner blocks as measuring tool to make sure that each side is at the same distance to one another. Here Here is the frame. It is light that it can be picked with one hand, but very rigid. That's it for this video. In the next video, I will be putting some smooth rods on the X axis and the Y axis. I'll be 3D printing some holders to hold the smooth rods, and I'll also be 3D printing some linear blocks to slide on the smooth rods. These corner blocks are made of aluminium alloy and then they are plenty strong. This makes the entire frame rock solid. I initially did not plan on etching or trying to engrave on aluminium, but I think I'm going to give it a try at the end of this series. The most difficult part of this project will be to cut this aluminium extrusions to size. If you have a miter saw, that would be great. Otherwise, like I said before, please ask your dealer to cut it for you. But make sure that he precisely measures it and cuts it, because most of the time they just rough cut it and it's not going to help us a lot here. I appreciate watching this video and be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss the next episode. Also like and share this video if you've enjoyed watching it. Sharing the video helps me a lot. Follow me on Instagram @MrJCRP to see what I'm working on right now. Until next time, happy learning!